Hello and welcome to this Take It Serious video. My name is Olivier and I'm the lead designer of this game. Today I want to show you where to find the game and download it, and cover the very first step in the game. So let's begin by going to this URL, ctll.e-ce.uth.gr, and then index/tes. Into this page, you will find a link to download the game and also the manual and a series of videos like this one. Click on download the game and you will be prompted with a way to download it. It's always going to be the latest version of the game that you will find using this link. Downloading the game will take a little bit of time because it's almost a 300 megabyte archive. But once it's downloaded, you'll be able to extract the archive wherever you want. Like so. And you will find a takeitserious.exe file that you can double click. Once you double click it, the game starts. And press space bar to start the game. The very first thing you'll be prompted with is a sign-in. So if you have an account, please enter your credentials, otherwise you will need to register. We will ask you for a username and a password, and also a first name and last name. If you're a teacher, you have been given a special code that you will need to enter here. I will sign in, as I already have an account. Once I'm signed in, I see here the teacher point of view, because my account is a teacher account. A very quick overview of the interface. We can leave the game by clicking on this button. Here hides the top menu. Speaking about the top menu, Home show displays my scenarios and public scenarios, slightly different for the student. I can access a help panel in which I will find a link to the manual and the instructional videos. If I go to settings, I can change the language of the game. I can also change the volume of all the sound in the game with the master slider, or only the music, or only the sound effect with those sliders. Finally, the visual window is going to allow me to change the graphical quality of the game. Also, I can display the amount of frames per second which are displayed on the game. The top number is the maximum number, the bottom number the lowest number, and the middle number the average number of frames per second. If I have some hardware limitation, I can also limit the amount of frame per second to a certain amount, or otherwise I can uncap it. Finally, I can also change the anti-aliasing process that the game is going to use. The last screen is the credits, where you will see the name of the person which have worked on the game. That's it for an overview of the game interface. I hope you will have fun playing the game. Thank you for your attention. Bye bye.